All right, guys, different kind of video today. We're just going to jump right into it. I'm going to show you how to take those animations you do in Fusion all the time and bring them to the edit page. Basically, I'm going to show you how to make your first macro. Jump in the Fusion. Now, this text plus template I've already set up, we're going to hit shift space and add transform. And this will work on just about any parameter. It might work a little bit different, but we're going to use size. We're going to go to modify, hit anim curves. With the modifiers, we're going to set source to duration, curve to custom, and we're going to set scale to 1. So left to right is time, and up and down is scale. I'm going to grab, for lack of a better word, this keyframe. I'm going to drag it over. Now, I want my animation to be about 20 frames, so I'm actually going to go to about frame 22, and then I'm going to come back to this keyframe we just moved. I'm going to adjust it until I get the size I want. I think that looks pretty good, so that's where we want our animation to stop. Now I'm going to come and turn our little line here red and click, and we create another keyframe. I'm just going to drag it over and make sure these two keyframes are flat. If you don't, you see how it keeps growing because these aren't flat here. So we'll just drag it down a little bit more. And you actually can box select both of those and hit F, and that'll help some. Now you might think that we could just create another keyframe at the end and create our off animation, and we could. There's a much easier way. We can actually just hit mirror. Now we animate on and we animate off. And you see it doesn't quite finish the off animation. That happens to you. Come and grab this first little keyframe at the bottom and just nudge it over a little bit until it disappears. This animation is kind of lame. I mean, it's fine. It's nice and smooth. We made it in Fusion, but we can do better. So our animation ends right about frame 22, like we were looking for. Let's go to frame 30 right here. And we're going to come up here in our little spline graph, and we're just going to click and we're going to add another keyframe. And just like in the big spline graph, we have handles when we select these, so we can change the way they curve. So let's select this middle one, and we're just going to play with a curve and see if we can get a little bounce animation. Something like that. I think this is a little bit too far. Let's see what we got now. That little bounce is a little bit slow. So remember, left to right is time. We're going to grab this keyframe and we're just going to drag it over. Now let's see what we got. Probably play with this keyframe a little bit more. So if you hold control, just like in the regular spline graph, it'll only affect one side of the keyframe. So we can drag this up, hold control again, drag this down, and get like a really roller coaster looking curve there. Let's see what we got. Right, that's pretty good. And then we still have our off animation. All right, now you just made an animation that uses no keyframes. Cool thing about anim curves are it's all based on a percentage of the comp. So we can drag this out as long as we want to, and we still have our own animation, and we still have our off animation. Now the only issue with anim curves is that it's a percentage of the comp. So if you do your animation the first 20% of the comp, that's what it's going to go off. If you make the comp longer, that 20% of the comp got longer. So your animation is going to slow down. Something to keep in mind. All right, now let me show you how to bring it to the edit page. So with all macros, I always like to add another transform right at the end, right before my media out. And this just allows me to move whatever I'm animating with one node. All right, let's take this animation to the edit page so we don't have to set it up in Fusion again. So we're gonna set this up where you can use it on anything, not just text plus. Video PNGs. So we just want to select our two transform nodes here. Right click, macro, create macro. Now the order you select these is important because it'll change how the controls show up on your macro. So I believe whatever you select first shows up at the bottom. We want our anim curves controls to be at the bottom. So we're going to select those first. We'll go ahead and we'll basically just add all of our controls. Now you don't have to add all your controls. Really probably only need this lookup control. And that's if you want to change your Anim curve animation. You want it to be completely the same every time. You really don't have to add any of these. But I'm going to add value, source, input, curve, in, out, lookup, mirror, invert, scale, and offset. And we'll add time scale and time offset. Now, our master transform is going to be transform 2. So let's find that. We want to add center. We'll add pivot. Size, aspect. We add both these and angle. Basically all the normal controls you'd have on a transform. All right, that should be enough. And we also want to add motion blur. So we should be in here in common. And then we'll hit motion blur, quality, shutter angle, center bias, and sample spread. And that should be good. Now all we have to do is name our tool. Let's name it pop in. File, and we're going to save as. We'll show up as a dot settings, and then there's your file name. I'm just going to save mine to my desktop. Now we can close this. I'll come up to your effects panel, and to get this on the edit page, all we have to do is save it in the right folder. You need to save it in this edit folder under templates. So we can right click, show folder. Now I might have some extra folders under here because I've added tons of macros. Once I built all that. So I'm going to go to effects and then I'm going to go to edit. You can see all my other macros that I've added. Here's the easy effects. If you want to check out easy effects, link in the description down below. But we're going to find our settings file we just made. Pop in and we're just going to move it into this folder. Sometimes you have to restart Resolve, but usually it just updates and then you can search it in your toolbar. So close this out. Now we just need to go back to the edit page and we just gotta look for it. Let's change this to all folders. Sometimes it takes a second to update. While we're actually waiting for that, let's go in here and delete animation. Let's see. All right, I had to restart Resolve, but as you can see, we got it right here. So we can just select it and drop it on our text. There goes our animation we made in Fusion. Just a click on the edit page. If we come up here in the inspector and go to the effects, you can see we got all the controls that we selected. All right, motion blur. We can kick that up. There we go, motion blur right on the edit page. Got all the options we need. We have our master transform. We can change the size, the position. We got our pivot, angle. There you go, you never have to do another pop-in animation in Fusion again. And down here, we have our Anim curve. You can adjust this if you want to. Say you don't want the out animation, uncheck mirror. And it's gone. Like, comment, and subscribe. We'll see you in the next one. Check out all my links in the description down below. Easy effects on my Ko-Fi page, Snap Captions, affiliate link, save 70% off a year subscription with audio. It's a hell of a deal. Don't miss it.